Being a wife of a soldier is one of those hard experiences to endure. From the minimal pay to living in long-distance relationship, coupled with heartbreaking moments when men are deployed in risk areas, the soldiers' wives have to endure it all. But it's the mega pay which puts the survival of a soldier's family to extreme test. Adoki Joyce is a soldier's wife who resides in Bombo Barracks. She narrates her ordeal then of having little to feed the family of six.
It's not so easy because my husband was getting something little. You know, men have a lot of loans. He has a big loan in Wazalendo.
Joyce's story is similar to that of Nalongo Annette, who describes a long stay in barracks then as a life. To Margaret, whose husband is at a high rank, the little they earned could not even take children to good schools.
Twali mu mbeera nga tetulina mirimu. Tubeera waka, okeera ku makya, bw'omala okusiimuula, ng'olinda kufumba.
Things change when it was not expected. I found Adoki and others busy making wedding cakes, mandazi, bread and cookies for the ready markets. This was after acquiring skills from the association formed for transformation.
Because now I can bake a wedding cake. It's now 3 years that we're baking Christmas cakes, UPDF children's Christmas parties.
We twafuna omusomo gwa private sector Uganda ne batuleta ano omusomo twatandika okugukenyo.
The ladies here say now they can even start up their own businesses even when their husbands retire from the army.
I can be a businesswoman, and because right now I'm in business.
From women of soldiers, the skills are now passed to the children of soldiers who say even when school fees becomes unavailable, they can earn a living.
I've learned how to bake cakes and bread.
Enyambi okufuna amagezi nti sometimes we mba nga mfunye sente so bulo tandika we yange nene kozesa.
Tailoring is another activity. Here is a 13-year-old that has taken opportunities of COVID-19 to make masks.
Can go and start my own business like tailoring, making clothes and other things.
That time they got a contract and they finished it very well. I hope with time, we shall be doing more than what you are seeing.
Mother Tim, the project coordinator, says having skills presents a lot of opportunities to women and the youth living in barracks.
Expect women to have powerful businesses because many of them are educating their children in their universities. They no longer ring to their husbands who are in Somalia or in operations. They are busy, at least they are standing in homes.
This satisfies her heart because the wives of soldiers can sustain their lives and even live a better life after the barracks.
These women are trained, they are empowered with skills, they are able to walk up and do something. These days, the husbands, even if a husband is transferred from one unit to another, a wife can remain where she is and she can do something.
All this was made possible with a grant from Private Sector Foundation Uganda.
We wrote and we also qualified and we are given a fund of 80 million, so which was to train 60 members of ROSA.
To help such enterprise to market and maintain standards to even be able to export, the Private Sector Foundation Uganda has organized a conference for small and medium enterprises to break even. Nabakoza Lydia, NBS, live at 9.